Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, now let's talk about prosperity for a moment. You know, we have these sayings, prosperity preachers, you know, prosperity this and prosperity that. Everybody wants prosperity. So quit letting people manipulate your thought process. You know, prosperity, everybody wants prosperity. I saw the preacher up there preaching, passing that tray 3, 4, 5 times because he wants prosperity. You know what I'm saying? Don't want you to have prosperity, but they want to have prosperity. So that's what it's about, being able to think and reason properly. So prosperity is the home. Let's get back to the foundation, the home. Food, clothing, shelter, adequate sleep, education. If you got some transportation, then you're a baller. You got it going on. Being able to nurture your family and take care of them, you have to be prepared to do that. The original Department of Housing, Education, and Welfare is the home. The home is the place where your nurturing and development should take place, right? And our program is designed to strengthen that unit, to empower that unit, to make sure our relationships are stronger. You know, the individuals make up strong relationships. And then that goes into your personal growth and development. The Temple of Inner Peace and Prosperity, that's the tip of the iceberg. That's our journey. You know, our journey is to overcome our lower beastly nature and to reach a more spiritual and divine level. That's what the life journey is all about, right? Then you've been hijacked. Your spirit has been hijacked and putting off into the wilderness because the course is narrow. Narrow is the way, all right? Then we're looking at another aspect of that same, you know, the zombie primal nature. You know, they got all these zombie movies going on, and it comes with personal growth and development. If you're not developed, your mind can't develop, even though you're a thinking being, but your level is that of the proper primal nature. You know, in a capitalist environment, it's very sophisticated. It's a very sophisticated set of laws and structures that you don't know about, but you hit that ceiling. You think that's everything. That's why you've been exploited. That's why millions of our children are locked up. You know, you have this oppression and poverty. You know, poverty is a mindset. The ghetto is a mindset. Let's break out of that, right? And I've been doing some substitute teaching lately, and wondering what's going on with the system. At first, you look at it and you've been indoctrinated, the system is failing our children, the system is failing our children. But then you look at it, you're like, wait a minute, you know, no system is perfect, but at least become prepared to engage the system. It's not and they're really trying to do great things in that system, right? You know, it's nothing's perfect. But we can't find out what the problem is until we fix our problem. You know, the problem is that our children aren't coming prepared to learn. They're not prepared to learn. They don't come with the paper. They don't come with pencils. Their mindset doesn't come for studying. They're disruptive to the whole classes. And I'm not saying all of them. Some of our students have buckled down. They're brilliant, you know, young people. But they're in the minority. They're in the minority. And they sit down there and shake their heads and so forth. And of course, they may engage a little in the ones that are being disruptive. But you got a handful of students that's disrupting the whole class, so the whole class can't learn. You know, cursing out the teachers, cursing out the principals. There's no discipline. There's no accountability. There's no structure. In our schools and other schools, they have that structure, discipline, accountability. You see a completely different mindset. You know. They have men on duty. You know, where in our schools, they have too many women in a place. You know, not of authority. It's not taken seriously. And then the men they do have are weak men. You know, and letting the children run all over them. If your mind is undeveloped, it leads to destructive habits, gangs, dysfunctional individuals, dysfunctional relationships, dysfunctional children, foster care, mass incarceration, poverty, and more. You judge a tree by the fruit that it bears, and the fruit is not very nurturing and productive. And these same young individuals that they kicking out of middle school, a lot of them don't even make it to high school, but they kick them out of middle school they can't function. They're not able to function. So you have adults that grow up dysfunctional, but they think that's normal. See, that we have all the chaos and the and so forth. You know, I'm not. We settle that part down, then we can really let the dust settle. Then we can really see what's taking place, what's been taking place. Then we go through our primal zombie nature, and then we get a little education, and we think we know everything. Can't talk to us. You know what I'm saying? We get these government jobs, and it's over. It's over. You know, then eventually you grow to the point of spiritual humility, you know, spiritual, realizing that, you know, the universe is vast, knowledge is vast, and I know nothing. Humility, humbling yourself. Basic necessities of life, like I talked to you before, food, clothing, shelter, adequate sleep. So let's see, I have that. You know, that's the basic foundations right there. Foundation, right? Then we have the way it's the people. Then we have government on top of it. Then you have the oligarchy, the small few, right? And the people, the largest segment of that is the people. Then you have government on top of the people and the oligarchy, right? But you have to understand that it is the people that could crush everything else. It's the people that's in charge. You know, it's the people that carries the clout, the weight. But the people, if the people are ignorant, you know, then, you know, left with a primal nature, then you have the world in decay and destruction, and our neighborhoods falling apart because we're relying on something when we should be relying on ourselves. Right? Okay, so that's a little thing about prosperity, the mindset and stuff. It's not about having millions of dollars and have a mindset of money. I've got my mind on my money. You know, it's about preparing yourself so you can live in a society, you know, and not be consumed by the things of this world. Alrighty? Zombie apocalypse.